Hello, I am back. So, I have been mixing up a lot of paint, and I have been sort of, I don't know how you say it, but you know, the colors, I don't know, I've never seen anything like it. I wish Leslie could make paint like this. If she could make acrylic paint this color, I'd be on that in a flash, because it's so beautiful. So, what are we going to do? Another experiment. Because I think about this time tomorrow I will make a real painting. But because I have, number one, the new paint, and number two, I have these pigments, I do have to go and, you know, just experiment just a little to see what I can come up with. And of course, I do this for you guys too, because some people are on a budget, and I understand that. And I'd like to do some experimenting to make that easier on you guys that want to do this on a budget. So, what I did is I mixed up some colors. These are just normal Winsor & Newton colors, just normal in the way it's paint. It's 20 to 30% pouring medium. No, sorry. About 10% pouring medium. And then I added about 20% to 30% of PVA. So I know that most people can get that PVA so cheap. So that's what I did. And I also did that for the pigments. So what you're seeing is paint, 10% pouring medium, and a lot of PVA. So you can even put more in, because, you know, we all know that when it dries clear. So, but that's also what I did in the pigments. These are the pigments from Colourarte. And, ooh, that's a plane. It's coming over really low, and we normally never get that. So the thing is about this pigment, and why it took me so long to get back to videoing, because I'm pretty used to a lot of paints, and I know how to mix paints, and I know what to expect, and all that kind of stuff. But this stuff is blowing me away, and I'm being very, very honest, because I'm sure that if this didn't work out, Leslie would want me to tell you guys, you know, just do not do this. It doesn't work with the pigments. But I just wish you could pick up what I'm seeing. This is PVA, people. PVA, you all know it. Let me get it. I am working with the archival quality. You know, it's this stuff. It's the white, milky stuff. So when you put that in those pigments, I was expecting those pigments to go totally flat because of the white PVA glue, but it doesn't. It just does not go flat. So even though it has the PVA, the color is, oh, it's so in your face. And this one has some sort of a shimmer in it, and I'm sure you can't pick that up, but it is like totally deep purple, a purple so beautiful I have never seen it before. And then when you look deep into it, you see this a sort of a lilac shimmer. It's just awesome. I'm sorry I'm so over this, but, and then this one too, when you look into it, you see it, that it's sort of a, you know, pinkish purple. But when you look deep into it, you see another color bouncing back at you, and that is so unreal. I've never seen so many. Look at the color, and this is a lot of PVAs in here. And if I did that, you know, with the acrylic paint, you could just see it go down. You know, it would go flat. And this pigment is so highly pigmented that I've never seen anything do what this stuff does. So I have a lot of colors, and this is the only color that turned a little bit different, but I'm positive once it dries, because it dries clear, it'll bounce right back. So what I have is three sorts of purple. I have the orange, and I have a sort of, let me get it. I will tell you the colors in case you want to do it. So this one is coral berry. So this is gonna, this one is going to turn lighter and turn into the middle color. Then I have this one. I have the snapdragon. I have terracotta rosé. I have boysenberry and wisteria. Those are the colors I have. And we are going to put just the plain paint on the canvas. So I have the white, and I picked out a really pretty color, a pretty pink. I mixed this myself. This is not a real color, but I wanted something to reflect these colors. So this is going to be just a test to see how these colors pop off, and I want them to really pop off the canvas. So what I would do is make sure that your paint is just a little thicker than you're normally used to. And what I want to do is build up a lot of these colors in the middle. I want to do a white on this side, and I want to do the pink on that side, and I'm going to swipe it up and swipe it back down. Now it's up to you to choose the dominant color, because when you swipe up and this is white and you swipe it up, you'll see a lot of stuff happening, a lot of cells popping. But then when you swipe it back down and you have your pink over here, your pink will be the dominant color because you swipe it back over the white. So you can choose. So if you want the white to be dominant, then you first swipe the pink and then come back with the white. And if you want a totally white, then I would lay down white on both sides. If you want the pink to be, you know, the most important color, then you put pink on both sides. So when you swipe up and down, you get all that pink. So that's pretty easy, right? And this is, you know, just a swiping technique. So in all these colors, I also put in a couple of drops of silicone, of course. Forgot to tell you that on the previous video, but I thought it went without asking because you all know I put silicone in everything. I would like to address the safety issues. If you're not totally comfortable with using silicone, please, please check it out first. Go to a doctor, go to someone who really knows, someone who has some scientific degree, and ask them about it. The thing is, what you should be doing is not, you're not burning that stuff. And that's the misconception a lot of people have. So if I were to do this, let's see, put the white on here, then let's see, a nice bright color. Oh, I don't want to contaminate my stick. It's all off. No, it's not. A little bit there. So if I were to do this, and then I take a palette knife, and I go over here like this, right? This is what we normally have on the canvas. What you do is do this. Look how close I am to my finger. But you're not really, you're not burning anything. See the cells that appeared? See that? What you don't want to do is keep that torch in one place, because that's not what you do. You just do this. And if you do that, you will feel, you know, it's not hot. It's just a little bit warm. Warm enough to, I think the what the torch does is make the paint just a little bit more fluid, so the silicone could pop up. But if you're torching and you're doing like this, you have that flame in one place, and the heat can really build up. You don't want to do that. That I would never, never, never say do that. That's good. When you see me torching like this, sometimes in a spot, well, I have like this much room between my torch and the canvas. So that is, I think I measured it once, you know, I hold it really up high. And then I just let the warmth work, and because you're holding it in one place, that's going to become a little warmer. So then the paint gets fluid and it releases that silicone. So it's absolutely not like shh and you burn everything, because that's not what we do. Silicone is has a sort of a range between, you know, what it can handle, and it is up to 480 Fahrenheit. And I'm telling you, if that was that warm on my hand, I would be doing another dance over here, so that's not what happens. Okay, gotta get my clean my hand a bit. See, but I thought that was pretty important, not only, you know, with this experiment, but, you know, overall, you don't keep that torch in one place. Please don't do that, because that's very dangerous, and I wouldn't want you doing that. And if you have any worry whatsoever, please do your art in a room where you have ventilation, where you have the fire extinguisher, where you have a fire blanket, where you have a CO2 alarm. I have one of those big ventilation things. I'll show you in a bit. Let's see, what else? Respirator, you know, lots of people use them when they're making art, especially the people that are doing resin. They all have these face masks on. Why not? If no one's going to look at you, no one's going to laugh at you, use one, because that is the smart thing to do. If you are worried, just do it. I'm not going to laugh at you if you wear face mask or scuba gear or whatever. I will never laugh at anyone who protects themselves, because I think that's very important. But there are also a lot of stories made up about this stuff, and I find that a little funny. Okay, I got my cup. And I'm not sure if I even need it, because what am I going to do? I am going to place the colors in the middle, like I said. So, you know, if you can, always give a little stir before you really put them on the canvas. And I don't want round blobs. I don't want that. I want it a little looser, little loosey-goosey. And remember that this is paint, 10% pouring medium, about 20-30% PVA to make it really cheap, and of course the lovely, lovely pigments of Leslie and Colourarte. So putting it in between here, because I think the colors I picked, you know, the pink and the white, are really going to pick this up. But I don't want it. I don't want the cells all to the end. I don't like that. Well, I do, but not on this one. You know, I just thought I'd do something a little bit different. And I know you guys all like that. So, see, nice color here. I think I'd like these in little blobs. Like that. So my sister was net. I was almost going to talk Dutch to you guys. My sister was here. She came for a cup of coffee with her husband, and I went downstairs. It was just after I poured that other canvas, so I went downstairs, and we had coffee and we had a nice little talk in the garden because it was dry and there was a little sun shining, and. She had a new car. She showed me the new car, beautiful car. And when I got back upstairs, you know what happened? I had left my canvas on this table, and this table isn't level. So the video I did before this one, where everyone was, "Oh, wow, beautiful, I want to buy it." Well, I'm sorry, but it had been a little bit off level, and a lot of the paint just fell off, so I had to do some damage control. But I still think it's beautiful, and I'll show you in a bit. Let's see, this color, we don't have this one yet. I'm gonna not use too much of this, but I do think it's gonna be really pretty once it dries. And I do want it coming back all over this bit. See, everyone can do this. Like, this isn't rocket science. You just get the colors you really like, and you just put them on the canvas and fill in the holes. Maybe let it level a little bit, and some over the other colors. That's nice. I hope I get those double cell colors. I should have made green. I should have. I thought about it. I thought, you know, you should put green in there too. And I didn't. That was pretty stupid. Okay, can't win them all. So, now I am going to do what I said I was going to do. Let's see. I'm going to swipe up and down. So, I want the white to be dominant. So I'm going to put some here, like that. A little bit more on the sides, because I like when the sides get just a little more action than the middle. There we go. So pretty easy, right? This is the easy stuff. Maybe a little more here, because it has a long way to go. So, big palette knife, where are you? Or should I do the squeegee? Because of course you guys don't have, like, all have this. Let me get the squeegee. Ooh, now I'm sort of nervous because I never did a squeegee this big. I think I did a little one. Let's see. Yep, you're still in focus. Yes. Okay, getting the paint to the corner. That's okay, don't worry. See, look at those cells, they're beautiful. And then pulling it back down. Yes, I need a brush. See, what I like to do when you have, when you see that little bit of bare canvas, I like to pick up the drop off and just, you know, work that into the canvas just while you're waiting for those things to pop. Just spread it down a bit. And then, because I said I like a lot of white, I'll put a little white on my brush and brush right over it. Very softly, like that. That's all covered. Little corner. Let's see here. Little corner here. That's it. Okay, torch, because I promised I would torch. To see if we get even more. Yes, that's nice. Look at that. See how fast I'm swiping? Because it's not about you bamp and do it straight away. If you think you don't have enough, you just keep swiping in one place like this. Okay, that's it. I do see a little bit of bare canvas here. Just have to work it in a little bit. That's it. Is that bare canvas? No, it's not. So the colors are gonna work. You can see the orange. You see it pushing through here and there. That's nice. So what this is going to do is it's gonna keep on working, because, and that was the first thing that I saw happening, and what I really, really liked is that once the cells are starting to form, with the normal paint, like maybe a minute, 2 minutes, but that was about it. You know, the colors would intensify, or the definition of the cell would intensify, but the overall color didn't much change. But with these pigments, you can see. I'm sure if you put back your if you do the rewind in the video, sometimes I do that when I see someone pour. You just see it move and grow and sort of do what it has to do. I don't know. But I kind of like that because that is very organic. So whenever you do this and you use these pigments, be prepared that when you first swipe, that's not your end result, because it's gonna live. It's living. Really, it is. Because those here, I'm pretty sure if you rewind, you'll see that these orange cells are starting to pop. And that's this color that I put in. So you will see that those are popping up. I'm very impressed with these pigments, people. Very much impressed. Maybe I didn't do a really good job of putting pretty colors together, but it's all for experiment's sake. And, you know, I wanted some contrasting colors, and I think I did that so that you can see what happens. And that's the important part of this video. It's all about experiment, and this one was about PVA. So it's safe to say that we can use PVA. I will be pretty much curious how this whole thing dries, and that these pigments will, you know, somehow dry differently and give some, I don't know, some really weird effect. That's what I'm hoping for. So this time I'm not going to leave it on this table. Oh, I will do you a little close-up though, but I'll do that with the iPad down. No, I still haven't got my big iPad. This is the little one. So they've had my iPad now for 7 days. Let's see, no, 8. Today's Saturday, yeah, 8. No, no, 9. Wow. I'm gonna call him. He said a week and a half. So that's, I think 9 days is the time when you start to bug them, right? Yeah. So let me get you down. Watch out for my little stabilizing thing that I paint. Okay, let's see if we can get this in focus. There you go. See how the cells are very, very different colors? I love them. There you go. But I really want to get this on cups pretty fast, because I didn't expect this table not to be level. My first table was pretty level. I think the only thing that the PVA does is the outline of the cells is a little hairy, if you know what I mean. But I'm not saying it like I don't like it, it's just different. So, see the hairy cells? But other than that, I think they are kind of beautiful. I wish I had my other iPad, because that one does a lot better job of close-ups. So I'm going to put this one up, and I am going to clean up again, and I might just do one more. Yeah, maybe a flip cup. Yeah, we haven't done that yet, have we? No. I'm going to do a flip cup. Okay, see you in the next video. Bye-bye.